real name is Rosemarijn, but that's a Dutch name, so a lot of people can't pronounce it, so Rose is okay. I was a long time was going to Tony Parsons, so I was really in a search of, and my way of searching was a lot of time was like personal growth. So I looked at myself and felt my feelings and things like that. And I was also a teacher in that, or I gave meetings about that. And then I had an ability about seeing things with people, so seeing the aura or things of people. And then suddenly in the meeting, everything fell away. So that was, in a way, it was annoying because everybody was, no, not everybody. I was more like, oh, what's going on and what can I do now? But for most of the people, they didn't even notice, I think. And it was just, it went to a conversation. And it was also a relief. Maybe you know the same thing, but it was a relief not to have that thing going on, to know somewhere to know, but still there was a me going on. And that did go on for years. And after that time, it was not that, how can you say, that strong anymore, but it still went on. And then there was a moment you could say the story, because it's all also talking in the story, and I will explain later why I do that. It's in the story, then I was somewhere, and then suddenly there was just everything. There was, and it's so, you can't explain it. It's just, there was no me, but in that, I can say it now, but in that moment, I even didn't know there was no me. There was just something not going on anymore, and it was just everything. And it was huge, and it was normal in the same time. It was very obvious that there never has been a me. It was so obvious and so normal, and I couldn't even believe there had always been that belief that I was someone. It's so obvious, it's so normal. And in a few years, I couldn't speak about it. I couldn't say, I didn't have the words. And then maybe after a few years, I can't remember so much the time. Then I was talking to some people, and they asked me to give meetings in my home. So we did it with a few people, and then it all started like that. And now I've written a book also that will be published in Holland now in February next year. And I'm busy with an English version, so maybe, I don't know if it's going on, but we will see. I hope so. So, and what was also very obvious, and that's a thing I don't hear so many people talking about when it's about spiritual teachers or non-dualistic teachers, that there is no world. There's only an apparent world. That's also very obvious. And then, so nothing is going on. Nothing did happen. So it was not that here in this body, there is no Rose anymore. There never has been a Rose. It's only in the story you could say there's a Rose and there's a body and she's walking, but there's nothing going on. Everything is just apparent. It seems to be very real, but it's not. That's also very normal and very simple, and in the same time, it's mind-blowing, of course.